Maybe we were using the wrong tool all along. So let me show you another tool to use using a fresh new example. What you see here is a map of the Netherlands. This is where we are in Delft. Suppose I want to take the train from Delft to Groningen. That's here. So there's no direct train, and we can see this on the map because the trains are the black lines on the map. And there's no direct train from Delft to Groningen. So how am I going to make this travel? I have two different options. Either I take the train to Leiden, that's here, or I take the train to Rotterdam, that's there. And from there, I can take a direct train to Groningen. So either I go this way, or I go that way. And if I want to calculate what the best option is, I also need to add weight to my arrows. So this one, from Delft to Leiden, will take me 21 minutes. From Delft to Rotterdam will take me 12. And then from Rotterdam to Groningen is 2 hours and 39 minutes. And this one is 2 hours and 28 minutes. So I can calculate my total travel time by summing these two and summing those two. And for this representation, I don't even need the map anymore. If I have my graph, my lines and my notes with all the numbers attached, I can just delete the whole map. There we go. And this is now a correct representation of my problems. I have a note, Leiden, Rotterdam, Delft, and Groningen. And I have arrows between them. This one, that one, and those two. And those arrows have weights. And this is called a graph, a representation of a problem in terms of nodes and arrows. And of course, you have imagined that we can use this same scenario, the same method, to analyze our Bacon problem. Let's have a look at the Bacon problem, how it looks like in a spreadsheet. We have actors and movies, and actors that have played in movies. And I can draw this problem like a graph too, like I did with the map of the Netherlands. I can say here is Kevin Bacon, and he has played in the movie Crazy Stupid Love. I just draw a line between the actor and the movie. And I can repeat this. I can add Emma Stone and Julianne Moore because they have played in Crazy Stupid Love too. And I can continue this process and make an entire graph of the problem that we are analyzing, who has played in which movie. And because we are representing it like a graph, you see that immediately your view on the problem changes, because it gets really easy now to calculate the Bacon distance from Bacon to another actor, because we can just traverse the lines in the graph. And that's what we're going to explore in the next video.